everyone. Day four of the finals here at the Rio de Janeiro Olympic Shooting Center, and it's the 50-meter pistol men's event. Our finalists have already had a long day of qualifications, but here they are to battle it out for one of those precious World Cup medals. Just a reminder, this is the Olympic test event, of course, so this is a wonderful opportunity for our athletes and for you at home to see exactly what they will be facing in August. So we'll be beginning with our finalists' presentations in just a few moments, but firstly I would like to introduce you to my guest commentator for this final, Will Brown from the United States of America. How are you?
I'm good, thanks, Dana.
Thank you for joining me. So we're just about to start. We'll speak to Will a little bit later on, but we're just about to start with the athletes' presentations. Will, firstly, I'm so sorry for not seeing you in this final.
Sorry.
So I always feel bad grabbing some of this just missed out, because you qualified in 12th, so yes. You must be happy with that.
Yeah, it wasn't too bad. You know, it wasn't a terrible day, but these guys earned it and I didn't, so that's all right.
Exactly. But yeah, we're just about to start with the presentation, so we'll hand you over to Shaq and Marcelo, and here we go. Oleh, Omelchuk came fourth earlier in the week for the 10-meter event and will be looking for a higher finish today. Pang Wei, he finished seventh a few days ago. Lots of medals to his name, but looking to win that elusive World Cup gold. Zhiwei has had an outstanding couple of years, World Cup gold already this year. Let's see if he can continue his fine form. So the current Olympic champion and world number one looking to add another World Cup gold to those five he already has. Mai Zhaiji, he already has three World Cup medals. The world number four is looking for his first of the year. Jay Shi, oldest of the lineup at 37, but making only his second appearance in a World Cup in this discipline. Wang Zhiwei, Olympic Games bronze medalist in 2012. This strong shooter will be looking for his third World Cup gold. So Kim Chung-yung, only 19 and has a World Cup bronze already. Let's see if the youngster can take that all-important gold. So Will, obviously there are a few people in there that were in your final earlier in the week. You took fifth place early in the week, so congratulations
Thanks.
For that. Sorry once more that
That's
you know
right.
You weren't in the medal spots, but still absolutely incredible to be on this range
right.
And ready for the Olympics. But this is how they line up. Quite an experienced lineup of athletes.
Yep.
A few
yep.
new faces. Your teammate, for example,
right.
it must be a proud moment for him.
Right.
To be
yes,
here.
Of course. Yeah.
Obviously, not being biased, obviously, as your teammate, but I'm sure you'll be rooting for
right.
Jay to take that today. So here we are. That's how they line up. Those who are not so familiar with the rules, it's just a bit like the 10-meter, basically. So there's two series of three shots, 150 seconds per series. So that's 2.5 minutes. This is followed by 14 single shots, a total of 20 competition shots overall. Eliminations begin after the eighth shot and continue after every two shots until our medalists are decided. So here we are, about to get underway with that first three-shot competition series. So Will, I was saying before we came on air, it's at least this way in qualifications, it's not an air-conditioned building, is it?
Right.
So they've sort of been able to get used to the heat for when they've come to this finals.
Yep.
And it looks quite similar, the light coming in from the roof.
It is very similar to the outdoor range, yep.
So here we go. The first three-shot competition series. How have you been dealing with the heat? Any preparation beforehand? Or?
No.
No.
Just got thrown into the fire.
It's just hot.
It's hot.
It's like having the sun directly at your face.
Yeah.
So here we go. Let's see who can get that all-important, perfect start. And really give themselves that best chance. Do you use these three-shot series? Obviously, you always want to score high, but... Mm-hmm. You just need to get these under your belt, do well, get up there, and just so you're not playing chase
right,
up pretty
right.
much, isn't it?
You never want to be trying to play catch up, but.
So the scores aren't as high in the 50 meter just because purely the distance is quite unbelievable, mm-hmm. isn't it? So there we are. Wang Zhiwei still to shoot. Kim Chong-yong there, just taking his time,
mm-hmm.
getting his composure. Yep, so an 8.0 by Rai, as you can see on the scoreboard. Pang with an 8.2. So they're all just getting their eye in, really, aren't they? They're just... How did you find the pressure, being in the final here, Olympic range?
I wouldn't say it was really too much different than any other final.
Yeah.
You're always going to feel a little pressure, but... That's just the way it is, man.
It's the way it is, of course.
If somebody says they're not feeling it, I think they're lying to you.
Exactly. You're very used to finals. You know, you took the World Cup gold in Fort Benning. So how did that feel, winning your first gold medal?
That was outstanding.
Yeah.
That was fun.
And to be in your home country as well.
Yeah.
Fort Benning.
Yeah, that made it all the more.
Yeah. Once that national anthem plays, it's one of those moments. There we are. There's the first three-shot series. Jin Jongoh leading the way in top spot. 0.9 separates him and Mai in second place. Towards the bottom of the table is Jin's teammate, though, is Kim Chong-yong in eighth place. We do see it change all day, don't we?
Yep.
And when you're up there, I'm sure you can't help but look at the scoreboard and think, so.
Yeah, there's really no avoiding it. I mean, I don't know about the rest of the guys, but I look at it.
Yeah, there's no, yeah. I think I'd be the same. You can't just ignore something.
It's like almost more annoying not to know.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Are there any of those athletes that when you see them on the line, you're like, oh, no. I'm against you? Or
No, I'd try not to think that way.
Everyone's a threat, aren't they? And just look at your own.
Everybody's here to win, or you wouldn't be here.
Exactly.
So there are definitely, you get guys like Jin or Omelchuk or... some of these guys with a lot of experience, and it's hard to ignore that.
Yeah.
But you just do your best, get up there and shoot good shots.
Absolutely. So Jitchu Rai here. Starting to see the scores climb up. 10.2 by Rai, let's see what he can do now. Yeah, so the current Olympic champion leading the way at the moment. Lots of experience, like Will was saying. It all comes into play here. Jay's currently in seventh, but still keeping in the mix, isn't he? 10.2 there, great shooting from him over 50 meters. So when did you start shooting? You're still quite young now. Are you
24.
Okay. Great. So when did you start shooting? For any young listeners out there that might want to get into shooting,
I started shooting competitively probably 8 years ago.
Yeah.
And it took me 3 or 4 years to get on our junior national team, and it just kind of went from there.
Right. And do you think it's just you just get the natural buzz for shooting?
I'm a pretty competitive person,
and so that always helps.
And you know, it was something that I was fairly good at, so it's fun to do.
Well, it's obviously proved right. So here we are. Jin Jongoh still leads the final after that second three-shot series. Mai is in second place. 2.0 separates them two, but obviously that can change very quickly. Omelchuk also tied for second. And we do move into the single-shot series now. So there'll be two more shots before we decide eighth place. And currently in eighth place and in danger is Kim at the bottom spot, but only 0.1 separates him in seventh. Some gaps starting to form, though, in sixth and seventh, yep. Jay and Pang. 2.2 separates them two, and 2.2 separates Pang from fifth spot. So here we are with the single shots. There's our leader, Jin Jongoh. That's from him. So still shooting really well. 8.5 on the right. Mai with a 7.8 there. He'll be a bit disappointed with that at this stage of the game. Yeah. But he still finds him in that fifth spot. So Jin Jongoh still in first place with an incredible 10.4, highest score of the round in that round. 7.9 from Kim Chong-yong, which means that he goes into eighth place, and he is in danger now, and a 2.2 separates him.
Yep.
So when you see that as an athlete and you know you've got 2.2, you just have to keep on shooting.
Yeah, you just gotta keep doing it, man. In free pistol especially, you know, you just never know what's going to happen.
Exactly.
It's not that hard for somebody to shoot a 7, you know. So,
yeah. And Kim is only 19 years of age. He's extremely young.
Right.
This is all experience, isn't it?
Yep.
Here we go. This shot will decide who takes eighth place in today's final. There's Kim. World rank number 12. At only 19. So 9.0 for Kim, but is it enough? No. Unfortunately, taking eighth place today is Kim Chong-yong of the Republic of Korea. But 19 years old, he took the bronze in Gabala last year, so an outstanding final for him. Got quite a nice crowd here as well. It's nice to see.
Yep.
Lots of support. I'm sure during the Olympics it'll be absolutely packed. And
yeah.
And I don't know how the sound's going to be in this absolutely aircraft hangar type type finals.
I'm sure it'll be loud.
Yeah, we weren't sure how the pistols were going to sound, and then when we get to the 25 meters, I think I don't know how loud they're going to be in here. So what sort of things, as a pistol shooter, what sort of things change over between 10-meter and your 50-meter? What sort of equipment do you change? And
just the gun.
It's just, yeah, just the gun. It's completely different.
I don't know about
it?
Everybody else, but you might do something a little different with the different lighting conditions as far as your glasses or something like that goes, but it's solid.
It's completely separate discipline.
Yeah, it's pretty different, but at the same time, you know, you're still shooting a pistol. All the fundamentals are still the same. So
after that single shot, Jin Jongoh still in top spot, but 10.5 by Pang. So great work from him. He's now into third place. We have the three Chinese athletes in third, fourth, and fifth all together there, all shooting very consistently and very well. Jay is currently in seventh at 1.2, and like we say, it can change very quickly. So hopefully he can shoot enough to jump into safety. Jitchu Rai with a 7.9 there, so quite low from him, but still getting his eye in, shooting well, shooting consistently. There is Jay. Currently in trouble, but can he do enough here? From Jay there. So that's it. He does look disappointed.
Yep.
But like we say, great effort from him. Great effort from your teammate. So I'm sure you'll be buying the beer for him tonight, right?
Right.
Yeah, so great shooting from Jay. Absolutely outstanding from the United States of America. Yeah, only his second appearance in the World Cup discipline, so absolutely outstanding from him.
Yep.
So this is how it stands. Jin Jongoh in top spot still leading the way, still doing very, very well indeed. 2.7 separates him and Mai in second place. Pang Wei in third, Omelchuk fourth, Wang fifth, and Jitchu Rai down in sixth place. Gap starting to form here, 3.3 between Jitchu Rai and Wang, so let's see what happens from here. How did you find it with the curtain across? One of my co-commentators commented that the colour wasn't ideal for when you're shooting pistol.
Right, yeah. Definitely when we were shooting our gun, I would say the lighting was pretty difficult. It's pretty difficult when you have so much light on that target and then the rest of the room is relatively dark compared to that. It just makes everything a little bit harder to see.
Yeah, of course. So after that shot, Jin still in the lead. Mai is in second, but it's Jitchu Rai with a 3.5 now, separates him and safety. So it will decide sixth place this next shot. Athletes slowly being eliminated every two shots until we have our medalists. But Jitchu Rai, very experienced. He's had, like I say, an incredible few years. He came onto the scene and he's just been shooting incredibly well, hasn't he? He's always a threat. Here is Rai. A gold medal already this year in Bangkok. This is for safety. .7 from him. Don't know if it will be enough, but a few 8.6 shot there. But yep, that is Jitchu Rai of India that goes out in sixth position. So the gold medalist in Bangkok, silver in Maribor in 2014. Also, he took the silver at the World Championships in 2014. Great shooting from him.
So, Mai of China, really good shot there. It was a 10.8, nearly the perfect shot.
Also, quite a few large names and big names didn't make it into this final today.
Sure.
So, a few shocks. Obviously yourself. Well, of course, but it's true. You did well earlier this week. Yep. You know, you're always... The confidence obviously goes on to the next event. But Tommy Yuki Matsuda is a big one not to be in here. And we've got Miketz, who's also in the final with you. Harumitsu Lee. There's lots of these athletes that just didn't make it in today. So all of these athletes shoot incredibly well because here you have the best of the best.
Right.
The best of the best. And if you're going to come out in top eight, absolutely fantastic shooting. Jin Jongoh, our leader. 8.1 there. And things can change very, very quickly. It doesn't seem to be much wind or anything coming from the top. It just seems quite still, doesn't it? And that's what makes it so hot in here, that the air is just still. There's nothing moving around.
Right.
So the gap is starting to close between top and second place. My breathing down the neck of Jin, 1.3 separates them. Wang Zhiwei is currently in fifth place, 0.9 separates him and fourth at this moment. So here we are, this next shot will decide who takes fifth place. Zhiwei, bronze medalist in 2012 at the Olympic Games. Shooting for safety. And 9.6 by Wang. 8.5, sorry, by Wang. So it's just not enough. It is Pang Wei that goes out in fifth place. It is his teammate Wang jumping up into fourth and into safety. So there he goes, Pang Wei.
Well, that was a very significant shot for the leader because
two Chinese athletes left in the top four. Wang currently in fourth, Omelchuk third. Second spot goes to Mai at the moment, and Jin Jongoh in top spot. So this is it, the fourth place that no athlete really wants to take.
Yep.
You've come that far, you've had the whole day of qualifications, and now the medals are just there. Oleh Omelchuk, she's been very consistently in the final so far. By Wang. Amazing what the pressure is in, isn't it?
Yep. Good shot from Omelchuk.
Absolutely. So there you go. Jin Jongoh with an 8.0. So Omelchuk is really closing the gap here. 0.9 separates them two. Wang is now in that bronze spot at the moment. And 2.4 below him is Mai in fourth spot. And this next shot will be deciding, unfortunately, which athlete misses out on the medals. So Mai is currently world ranked number four. He took a World Cup gold in Gabala last year and two World Cup silvers. So very experienced. This whole lineup of athletes is absolutely incredible. So we're really going to witness an incredible final here. Wang Zhiwei. So there he is. Wang with an 8.9. So fourth place goes to Mai, though. Just missing out on the medals. Still an incredible final. Mai Jiaji. So I just saw him there moving his shoulder. It's obviously quite strenuous shooting pistol.
Yep.
I can't even imagine all day up and down. So you obviously have sports physios and things like that that work on you. You bring people out with you, don't you?
Of course, yep.
So what gets affected the most? It's the shoulder, is it the back? You know, because standing all day in that unnatural position, really.
Probably certainly the shoulder takes the most strain, but it's kind of a whole body workout almost, you know?
Absolutely. It's all about having the core, isn't it? And then working on everything else around that. So here are our medalists, our top three. Omelchuk in second place now, but so, so close. 0.6 from that gold spot. See what he can do. Omelchuk with a 9.6. Jin Jongoh still to shoot. 10.0 So this is it. It's time to decide which athlete takes the bronze medal home. Jin Jongoh in top spot, leading the whole way, which is...
Yep.
The Olympic champion is absolutely outstanding, but we would expect it. Jin Jongoh, Omelchuk is in second, 1.0 separates them now. And in that bronze spot now is Wang Zhiwei. So this next shot for the bronze medal. Shooting for Wang. Tempo waiting for him. 9.7 for Jin. 10.2 from Omelchuk. So it is Wang that takes that bronze medal home. So he took the bronze at London 2012 as well. So incredible shooting from Wang. Lots of support from him. So the three Chinese athletes finishing third, fourth, and fifth. Very, very good for their team as well. He seems very happy with that. So this is how it stands for our two athletes. Jin Jongoh still in the lead, but 0.5 separates him and Omelchuk. So it's still extremely, extremely close. He is closing the gap here. And these are our final two shots. I feel like I'm slowly melting, so I don't know how they feel. So if you see me struggling beside you, I'm sure it is. They have the pressure. It's all about keeping the heart rate low, keeping hydrated. Jin Jongoh, our leader. 9.4 from him, and 10.7 from Omelchuk.
That'll work.
That'll do it. There's any time you want to jump up into the top spot, it's right now. So Omelchuk, 10.7, absolutely amazing at this stage. He has now jumped into top spot for the first time, and Jin Jongoh has moved into second. 0.8 separates them both. But this is what we like. It's exciting,
right,
isn't it?
It makes
it a little bit different. Lots of changes. Great for the crowd. Great for the sport. So this next shot will decide which athlete takes that World Cup gold medal here in Rio de Janeiro and which athlete takes home the silver medal. You can see all the photographers around getting ready.
Yep.
That's it, Omelchuk at the front of the picture with Jin Jongoh in the background there.
I like that paint job.
You like? So here we go. This is it. This is what it comes down to. Chin shooting early with it.
Open the door.
Yep, open this 8.6. And a 9.7 for Omelchuk, but that's enough. So there we are, the gold medalist from Ukraine, Oleh Omelchuk. Absolutely astounding. He did amazing in the last final he was in, and now the gold medal here. So absolutely thrilled with that. Silver medal goes to Jin Jongoh, the Olympic champion. Amazing. Great for him to shoot so well here before the Olympics. And Wang Zhiwei in the bronze medal spot. So all doing well under the heat, under the pressure. And thank you so much for joining me.
You're welcome. I really appreciate it.
Honestly. Sorry for just sort of stealing you from your friends.
No, that's all right.
And you fly home tomorrow?
Yep.
So safe journey.
Thanks so much for joining me.
I massively appreciate it. All right. Yep. So here we are. One last time, just to confirm our three medalists. So the bronze medalist representing the People's Republic of China, Wang Zhiwei. The silver medalist representing Republic of Korea, Jin Jongoh. And the gold medalist representing Ukraine, Oleh Omelchuk. Thank you so much for joining us today, and we will see you next time. Thank you.
Jin.